Believe it or not, there are over 650 muscles in your body. Obviously, it will be crazy to learn all of them, but it makes sense to familiarize yourself with the major muscle groups that can and should be trained for a stronger and more athletic body. As you will find out, any good workout program will focus on all important muscle groups so they all grow in balance and proportion. This also prevents injury, improves posture, and will help you feel more energized and confident. In this video, I will give you a general overview of the body's six major muscle groups: chest, back, arms, shoulders, abs, and legs, along with their functions. In the following video, we will then talk about each and more in detail and show you how to train them correctly. First, the chest. The main muscle group of the chest are the pectorales. The pectorales are full of thick muscle fibers and add size to your upper body. The pectorales can further be divided into two parts: pectoralis major and pectoralis minor. They are activated mostly through pushing movements and mainly at the shoulder joint. The most commonly known gym exercise to train the chest is the bench press, of course. Next, we have the back. The back is one of the most complex muscular structures in your whole body. It is a perfect combination of multiple muscles working together to hold up your upper body and perform physical activities. The back rises from your buttocks and stretches to your shoulders and neck. The most important muscle groups in the back are the latissimus dorsi, rhomboid, trapezius, teres major and minor, and the spinal erectors. Most of them are trained through pulling exercises like rows or the deadlift. Third are the arm and shoulder muscles. The three main muscle groups here are the biceps, triceps, and the deltoids. The biceps are found in the front of the upper arm and help bend or curl the arm towards your body. The triceps are located in the back of the upper arm and helps stabilize shoulder joint as well as following elbow joint to be straightened. The deltoids or delts are your shoulder muscles. They move your arms and provide support when you carry things. Now, before we go on to the next muscle group, I should say one thing. Even though it's a major goal for most beginners to get bigger arms, you shouldn't train them direct a whole lot during the workouts. I go over the difference between isolation and compound movements in a different video. But for now, just keep in mind that most beginners focus too much attention on these muscle groups. Fourth, we have the abdominal muscles, and they are the favorite body part of many people, and pretty much everyone wants a six-pack. But your abs don't just look good, they also assist you in breathing and protect your inner organs. They are vital for twisting motions and help maintain good posture. The muscle group to the sides of the abdominals are called the obliques, and they kind of look like fingers when you have a low body fat percentage. And lastly, we have your leg muscles. The main ones include your quadriceps, hamstrings, glutes, and calves. Together, they allow you to walk, run, and jump. Your legs should generally be trained through heavy compound exercises like squats, lunges, or deadlifts. But because they are so complex and made up of so many individual muscles, there are few things to keep in mind, which we'll talk about later. So now that you have a general overview of the main muscles in your body, let's go through each and more in detail. This will help you train them optimally and ensure fast growth and strength gains. If you enjoyed this video and want to hear from me again, be sure to hit the subscribe button before you go. If you have any questions, comment below, give me a like, and just follow me to don't miss one of my videos on YouTube, Instagram, and Facebook. To your success, your health, and wealth, mentor.